Okay. So, now, mathematicians wondered what would happen. I'm going to draw this thing again, I think. Let me see. I want to draw it again. I think that's what I want to do. I need to make these approximately the same distance apart. Hold on, I'm being super sloppy. 2, 4, 6. And then up here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, and then we had these points, and I'll just put them on here again, 0 and about 4.9, and then what other points do we pick? Oh yeah, 3, 6, and then 10, 8, right? And then 19, I think, was my other nice point. 19, 10, right? Okay, so I got something like this. These are the same points we used before. Okay. Now, mathematicians want to know what happens. And let's choose a different point. Let's say I want to go from 12 out here. I just kind of want to, 22, 24. Okay. So let's say I want to know what happens in this second 12 months from here to here, right? Okay, so it's possible to do the same sort of analysis, do this average rate of change. But so what happens, actually, so the question starts out like this, and then mathematicians say, okay, that's all great. What happens when I move this second dot closer and closer to the first red dot? And so this line, like these two dots are getting close together, and so really, do you remember in the limit where we really talk about doing finding limits really close by? So in the limit, I'm letting this kind of distance go to zero. I get closer and closer, and then finally I get a line, so like maybe I get all these green lines, but then finally I get a line that just kind of barely touches right there. This line that only touches at one point is called the tangent line. And these two points, these two red points that I let kind of grow farther apart, are sometimes called x and x plus h, or sometimes you'll see in your book a and a plus h. One of them is meant to denote that a is actually a number, and x is kind of a variable, but in the broad picture, they're practically the same thing, right? So this is called this, and so when we look at this same sort of slope, and when I look at plugging a plus h into this function, this slope, y2 minus y1 over x2 minus x1, when I have a function, it looks like f of x plus h, right, minus f of this first point x over x plus h minus x. And these two x's, x minus x in the denominator, cancel, and you'll get f of x plus h minus f of x all over h. Okay? Now, this quantity has a name. So you'll see in your book that, again, this is another form of the average rate of change. This is the definition that you'll do in your book. Sometimes if you just are supposed to compute it, that other one where you remember the slope formula, I think, seems easier and or more memorable. But average rate of change, it's also, if you took calculus before, called the difference quotient. Okay, and then pretty close by, like a small change, which I'm going to write in red, if I let this h get really small, that is, I bring these points really close together, that's a limit as h goes to 0 of this same thing. And this quantity right here is what we call the derivative. It's also, another name for it is instantaneous rate of change. Especially if you plug in a point here. It also gives you the slope of the tangent line. Okay, so this idea of limits, of letting kind of things, like looking close by, or in this case, like letting it get close to zero. So I have to use a limit. Do you see this? Because I can't set h equal to zero, or this quantity doesn't make sense. I'm dividing by zero. But we just let h get really, 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 really small. And bring those two points closer and closer and closer and closer together, and then it's almost in the limit, like they're on top of each other. And so we get this kind of sense of what the slope is right here. Without having to use two points, we get this kind of point slope, okay? Okay, so